So when you think a deliberate thought of what you want, then law of attraction will employ the universe and all people, circumstances, and events to move you to what you've asked for and to move what you've asked for to you. And so if you think about that, there is just action would be really, really hard for you to reach all of the people, circumstances, and events, manipulate all of them to receive what you want. And if you really reflect well on your life and things that have happened in your life, you'll kind of see that actually that happened for me. All I did was move to here, or all I did was move to there, and I received what I wanted. Thought creates all of the appearances in the world, and thought creates everything in your life. So it's pretty darn powerful, right? And what you think about is what you get. What you focus on is what will manifest in your life. And everyone is manifesting their day every single day. We're doing it. We are not aware, of course, necessarily of thoughts, but thoughts come, we energize them, and then they will manifest unless we cancel that thought out with another thought, with a thought that contradicts it. But I remember Lester Levenson would say, every single thought manifests. And I just thought that was incredible. I had known the secret for years and years and years. And Lester Levenson was a real master. And he said, every single thought manifests. And I was just, wow, that's how powerful they are. So thoughts are your superpower to be, do, and have what you want to experience and have and do in your life. And so if you ask an athlete, or if you talk to a coach, a really brilliant coach, right, of a sports team, then you will find that visualization and these principles that I'm talking about are a big part of their training. They have to be. They have to see themselves winning the game. They have to see themselves winning the match. There is a really incredible tennis player that's a very big fan, a champion tennis player that's a really big fan of The Secret, who uses The Secret. This is what he does. He sees that he has won the match before he walks out onto that court. And it's the same for teams. It's the same for athletes in the Olympic Games, running a race and seeing that they've won. Yes, they run the race, but what has them win the race is that they saw themselves winning before they even got on the starting block, and they saw it and believed it and felt it, and so they just, everything lined up for them in the perfect way. They drew the perfect lane. Everybody else was moved in exactly the right position, and they got a really great start and they won the race. And so thought is just so, so powerful. So athletes, but also, do you know, the astronauts in the Apollo program did visualization before they went to the moon, and they visualized landing back on Earth safely. And so that's how important visualization is. Just thought in pictures, by the way. It's still thought. It's just the same thing, okay? It's just thought in pictures. So if you took a person who had zero resistance and you locked them in a room, if you took a person that had zero resistance, that person thought about what they wanted, zero resistance, locked them in a room, what they wanted will come to them. The universe will move people, circumstances, and events and bring that right to them. It absolutely must, because if you have no resistance, you have unleashed a law that just cannot be stopped. And so you will manifest. It will come to you. Now, one of the things that I think so many of us have, and which is why I wanted to talk to you about thoughts being more powerful than action, is many of us have the world belief that we have to work hard and struggle to have money to get anywhere. And I'm not saying that you don't take any action, but what I am saying is Your superpower is to think and see what you want before you act, because then your action will be effortless, absolutely effortless. Now, if you just think about it too, action, you can't move without a thought. You can't take any action without the thought that you're going to act. Like, for example, let's say that you wanted, no, let's try this. So let's, right now, I want you to act without a single thought. Can you do it? Can't do it. Can't do it? No, babe. You've got to have a thought first. That's like the power of thoughts. So I want to talk to you about the secret. When we made the Sacred Documentary, because the Sacred Documentary reached hundreds of millions of people across the planet. Now, it's impossible for me and the Sacred team to have got the movie personally into the hands of those hundreds of millions of people. And I want you to know what we did with the Sacred, because this is a perfect example and may help you for manifestation in your life. Hi, everybody on Facebook. Hi from India. So much love to everybody there too. Thank you so much for joining me. So now, we visualized the secret bringing joy to millions. We visualized, we intended, we held that dream in our mind constantly while we were making the documentary. I can say from my perspective that I held that dream of the secret bringing joy to the world 24/7. Every breath that I took is that dream was held. And we actually had intention meetings every morning at 11 a.m. The entire team came together and we all together collectively saw the secret sweeping the world. We saw the secret being featured on Oprah. We did all of everything that you saw happen in the world, we had intended every single day in our intention meetings. So then, yes, we took action to make the documentary, but I want to explain to you the difference because of what we did. The action that we took was to receive what we had asked for. So let me think of an example. So there were many teachers that I wanted to have featured in The Secret. We were based in Australia at that time. The whole team and I came to the United States. We did not have one single teacher lined up, not one. There was one teacher that I really, really wanted. I'd read every one of his books. That was Bob Proctor. Another teacher that I really, really wanted was Jack Canfield. And my sister was contacting all of the teachers and telling them the story, my story, of how I had discovered the secret and what we wanted to do. And so she hadn't had any luck with Bob Proctor, but she had with Jack Canfield. And Jack Canfield happened to be in Aspen and said and told us, fly to Aspen and I'll you can film me. And then he said he wanted me to do a presentation. He had a big kind of meeting that he was holding in Aspen and he with a lot of teachers, and he wanted me to do a presentation to all of those teachers. I'd never done that before in my life, but anyway, I showed the trailer and I did a presentation, and I was like, I can remember that day, that night, I just knew that this is just going to be the most incredible thing in the world, because this would set people free. And they would be able to have the life that they deserved. And so I did the presentation, and Jack Canfield said, announced to the room, if anybody would like to be filmed for this documentary, step forward now. And the whole room stepped forward. All these teachers, we just went there to film Jack Canfield, but all of these teachers, do you see how incredible that is? That could never have happened if we hadn't intended and saw the universe moved, people, circumstances, and events for us to receive what we had asked for. Now let me tell you about Bob Proctor, because while we're filming in Aspen, my sister finally managed to talk to Bob Proctor's personal assistant. And so my sister explained my story, because when the teachers heard my story, they knew that I was authentic. And so she explained my story, and Bob Proctor's assistant said, "Where are you now?" And my sister said, "We're filming in Aspen." And she said, "Oh my God, we are here in Aspen." And so do you know, when she went and told Bob Proctor, he knew, because we were filming in Aspen and he was already in Aspen. He knew this was meant to be. And he was over sitting in the chair to be filmed within a couple of hours. And so we filmed Bob Proctor. And that, I can tell you, is just one of the tiniest things that happened with the making of the secret documentary. Everything that we needed came to us. And I remember the team, we would say, we could make a movie about the making of the secret documentary, because it was just so many incredible stories. But all of this that happened, everything that happened for us, because we saw it in our mind. We saw the joy that was going to come to the world, and we never, ever let go of that. And everything we needed, technically, teachers, content, footage, whatever we needed, was effortless for us. And so if you ask any one of the secret team if thought is more powerful than action, then we know it is the case. We know it. Hi, I think it was Kim from West Sussex. Hi, Kim. "The secret changed my life, Darius. Thank you so much. It makes me so happy to hear that, really and truly." Hi, Melissa. So thank you, everybody, for joining us. It's just so sweet of you to be here. Thank you so much. Okay, so I've got my computer here to look at your questions. Okay, so I hope that that explanation and talking about thoughts are more powerful helps you understand that if you use your mental powers before you act, you have the power of the universe at your back, moving through you and moving through the world, people, circumstances, and events. You can see what happened to us in Aspen occurred through people, circumstances, and events. Okay. Oh, thank you, Elaine Barrett, so much. She said, "I bought your new book and absolutely love it." Oh, I'm very teary today. Oh, thank you so, so much. Okay, so let's do some questions, yeah? Hi, Rhonda. "Whenever I want to manifest something, I will be giving that thing my attention." That's right, you will. "I get to see glimpses of the things that I want to manifest after thinking about them, but they are just glimpses. They've never truly manifested. So I guess if I want to manifest anything, I have to think about them with the feeling that it's already in my possession. If not, they will just be glimpses and not manifest. Am I right on this?" And this is from Idham from Singapore. "Yes, you are right in that you need to feel as though you have your manifestation in your possession, for sure. I mean, sometimes it's possible to just think something and it manifests too. But if it's something we really want, we kind of need to pull in all of our power, right? We need to bring in feelings as well, and really kind of get behind it and sort of supercharge it. But I want to just say with glimpses, because I know what you mean by glimpses, but if you want, you can interpret glimpses as a sign of land that your manifestation is about to arrive, right? And you know a sign of land, like sailors when they're out on the ocean, and a sign of land would be seeing twigs on top of the water or something like that, or seeing some birds flying overhead. They would be signs of land. They know land is close by. And so I would always use glimpses as a sign of land, and I would be like, oh, it's coming, it's about to arrive. And so maybe that will help you. Maybe that will help you if you see glimpses as a sign that your manifestation is about to arrive. Okay, from Slovenia, I've read The Greatest Secret. I have to say it helped me tremendously on my spiritual journey. I'm feeling really good. I'm trying to manifest something, but there's one thing that keeps repeating in my head. I've heard, and I also know people who without a doubt knew that they were going to manifest something, but in the end it didn't happen. One of my friends knew for certain that she was going to get a certain job, but at the end she didn't get it. In the book it says if you know that something is yours, it has to manifest. So why did these people not manifest their desires? Okay. The law of attraction, which governs our mind, never makes a mistake, ever. It's a law and it's infallible. So for example, it's the same as the law of gravity. So imagine a sidewalk and people walking down a sidewalk. All of those people are being held to the sidewalk by the law of gravity. You don't see a couple of people just float off into the air and think, oh, the law of gravity stopped working for them, you know. They're just like floating off. There goes a few more. Off they go. No, everybody, the law of gravity is holding everybody all of the time. And so it is the same for the law of attraction. The law of attraction just doesn't slip up. And so if it didn't manifest, even though the person thought they felt that they knew they were going to get it, the law of attraction did not receive it in that way. The law of attraction received that they didn't get it. It's just the way it is. So I think it helps a lot if somebody is, I was so sure. Then you get to examine the way that you felt. And because believe me, I experimented with everything. I would see that something didn't manifest, and then I would see something else manifested really easily. And so I would think back to what was the feeling that I had when that other thing manifested so easily. So it works. Law of attraction works every time. Wow, just like gravity. I thought I would have ages and ages to talk to you about all these questions. All right. I'm a learner and I sometimes feel doubt about what I'm practicing, whether it's right or not. And am I on the right track? Am I on the right path? I'm choosing this because a lot of people have doubt, but I just want you to know doubt comes from the mind, and they're just thoughts, and the reason that they're appearing is because you have a belief that is saying that you don't have this already. But just don't give those doubts any energy, and work harder on feeling that you have your manifestation, because when you believe you have your manifestation, no thoughts of doubt will come. When you believe you have it, you have overridden any other belief in the subconscious mind. You've reprogrammed your subconscious, and then it will manifest. So just remind yourself that you are the power that creates everything effortlessly. You are that power. So just take it. It's not an effort. It's really easy. You know, it's really easy. Just take it easy. Let go of the doubtful thoughts. From Joy. How do I feel happiness constantly? I've been doing the welcoming practice. It's been amazing, but sometimes I feel low and don't understand why. And so I'd like to just answer Joy, and seeing she's doing the welcoming practice, she's going to know exactly with this answer. And I think this answer will help other people. Hi, Detroit, Michigan. Hi. The only reason that you feel low is because your mind has come back, right, and has taken over. That's the reason that you feel low. You felt amazing when you did the welcoming practice, because when you do the welcoming practice, the mind goes into the background. And so you feel low because the mind has come back into the foreground. So I just want to give you something really quickly to welcome the feeling of feeling low. Welcome feeling low. So when you have that feeling of feeling low, welcome that feeling of feeling low, and you will dissolve it. So just keep welcoming until you've dissolved it. And then all of the happiness is that was underneath the low feeling will be revealed, and you'll be happy again. It's really great. I know you will be able to do it. I could tell by the way that you wrote the question that you will definitely be able to do it. It'll be an aha moment for you. Hi, Lindsay from Dawson Creek in Canada. George, you find the welcoming practice in The Greatest Secret. The welcoming practice removes all negativity. So I'm just going to keep on going here. What's the most powerful thought? Asks Lucia. A thought that is for the good of everyone. So, for example, if you ask for abundance, ask for yourself and ask for everyone. That is the most powerful thought. But I want to give you something else to just kind of think about a little bit. Another powerful thought is one that allows everyone and everything to be just as they are. That thought has more power than anything. When that thought becomes your life, the way that you live your life, where you allow everyone and everything to be just the way it is, then you will be free. You will be in permanent happiness. Your life will be extraordinary. Everything you've ever wanted will just fall into your hands. That's what happens when we can just be okay and just fine with everyone and everything. And I think that this is a really good time in the world to mention that, right? Because a lot of people are getting very emotionally charged, and so just, yeah, if you can just be fine with everyone and everything, that will be something else. Is thinking that every manifestation needs action to become a reality a limiting belief? Yes, it is. Yes, it is. Somebody asks, Hodnissen asks, how to improve a relationship with thoughts. Make lists of all the things you appreciate about the person and about the relationship. And keep making that list until you feel a change within yourself and until you see a change in the relationship. And then when you see a change in the relationship, you know that the inner work that you did made that change. All you need to do to maintain it is just look for the good in that person every now and again, and everything will stay beautiful. How does writing our desires make them manifest easily? When you write out your desires, for a start, you become really clear about what you want, and you know with the creative process, ask, believe, receive, is that step one is ask. So you need to be really clear about what you want, right? So when you write something down, you get clear, and so that means you've asked. And because you're giving your attention as you're writing all of them down, you are using your superpower of thought to manifest, right? You're focusing on your desires. Oh, Australia, I saw Australia. Hi, Australia. Hi, Malaysia. Okay. Tusna Ravi asks, is follow the flow a right method of living, or should we make decisions for our life? My personal feeling about this is I love going with the flow. I really do, because I have found that life will present to me manifestations far greater than I could ever imagine with my mind. And so I'm really just these days letting everything go, because life does a way better job than me. I can't even think of things that are more fantastic than what life does. So how to manifest love? You manifest love by loving everything. That's how you do it. You fill yourself up with love, absolutely to the brim, overflowing. Every day, pick out everything you can see that you love. And oh my God, you watch what happens to your life. You just watch. Okay. This person says, many law of attraction trainers state that action is very important along with thoughts. Just thinking about becoming a billionaire won't make one a billionaire. You need to act. So I didn't say you didn't need to act, but I do want to share a story with you. Sarah Blakely, the CEO of Spanx, asked for a $1 billion idea. And she received the inspiration for Spanx. And it certainly became a $1 billion business. But because of the way that Sarah went about that, Sarah's experience of turning that idea, for a start, she had the wherewithal to know without a doubt that she had been given a $1 billion idea. She knew it. And so she followed through on that idea. And she therefore would have been, the universe just would have lined up people, circumstances and events for her. It would have helped guide her so she didn't go down the wrong track with products. It would have helped her see mistakes early on before she went into manufacturing. It would have guided her, would have presented her with the most fantastic people, with the most fantastic fabrics and everything that she needed to make that a $1 billion business. There's no way Sarah Blakely could have created Spanx without asking for that $1 billion idea. Do you see the power of thought? It's incredible. And you have that power. So let me see. I just want to find something else. How to be more positive and control the mind and not to think negative thoughts. I don't think many of you would have that problem, would you? At all? No? The more aware you can be of your thoughts, the less you're empowering negative thoughts. So it really comes down to your awareness. And it doesn't matter, look, if you go down a rabbit hole with a whole lot of thoughts in your head. And what matters is that you realize, oh my gosh, I went down a rabbit hole with all those thoughts. Because every time you can see that you followed thoughts, is you're weakening those thoughts and you're weakening the grip of the mind on you to kind of hypnotize you. It's a feeling of like being hypnotized, isn't it? When the thoughts are just constantly, constantly going in your head. So the more you can become aware of your thoughts, the less you empower them and the freer you will become. And you get to a point where you are completely aware all of the time, and then your mind is in the background and thoughts just don't bother you. And instead you use your mind for what it was meant for. And what was it meant for? It was meant to create whatever you want in this world. That's what the mind's for. So should we think of a plan B while practicing manifestation? From my own experience, I never spent time on a plan B because I felt if I gave my attention to a plan B, it would manifest. So I gave all of my attention to plan A. It's okay to have a rough idea what you might do in a plan B, but just don't give your attention to it. Give your attention to plan A. So that is the one that manifests. Can we manifest 2 to 3 desires at the same time? Yes, of course, and make a list. You can. And sometimes it's even better to have a list of all of the things you want, because you would have less resistance around a list than if there was this one thing that you're like, I want to get this one thing, because that's resistance. See that? So if you've got a list, you might be more relaxed. And the thing is, then you will see things on the list manifesting and you'll be like, yes, and it will strengthen your belief in the incredible infinite being that you are, that can be, do, or have anything. So somebody has asked how to manifest positive thoughts. And I want to say you're manifesting positive thoughts all of the time. And so has anything good happened to you this year? Who was it who asked this? Vasa, did anything good happen to you this year or this month or this week? Because all of the good things that happened to you this year are your positive thoughts that manifested. Okay, you're manifesting really positive things all the time. We just don't kind of notice them, you know, so much. It's really interesting. Suzanne Love has said, your thoughts create your actions. Absolutely, they do. Action is preceded by a thought. You're absolutely right, Suzanne. And how can I stay positive when I'm surrounded by negativity on a daily basis? Do everything you can to keep feeling good, right? All the secret shifters and all of those things, because if you get yourself onto a different frequency, law of attraction won't put you in the same place as that negativity. But at the same time, I would give you this tip. Look for the good in the negativity. I promise you it's there. I promise. So look for it and see if you can find it. How can we ask the universe to help make a decision if we don't know what we want and we don't know which way to go? Say to the universe to show me clearly which is the best path for me to take. Show me clearly, leave me in no doubt whatsoever. I've used it over and over again. Works every single time. All of these things I'm giving to you, I have used over and over again. So, okay, and I just wanted to get down to one fantastic question. DJ Grenlow. So if you think about winning the lottery but don't buy a ticket, how are you going to win? Well, somebody buys you a lottery ticket for a birthday present and it's the winning ticket. That's how you win, without buying a lottery ticket. So there's always infinite ways, right? Always infinite ways. But I'm not telling you not to act. I am just suggesting to you, inviting you, to use the power of your mind before you act, okay? And then you will just find life is so much easier. So before you go to bed at night, intend your day the next day. I do it all of the time. When I have this life, I'm intending the night before when I wake up. I am intending that I will find the perfect words that will help all of you. And so just intend everything. Intend your life. And it'll be an amazing life. I want to give a shout out to my sister Glenda in Australia. And if she's up, it's like 4 o'clock in the morning and you should be asleep. And I want to give a shout out to absolutely every one of you. I love you so, so much with all of my heart. Thank you very much for being here. You are the best. You are the best. Thank goodness this world has all of you in it. Much love. Bye, everyone.